This is our first full-length record, so doing that for the first time, it's like really seeing every step of the process, every detail, every little thing, and having a hand in it in one way or another. There's obviously a lot more work involved than when you just show up to play bass or drums or something, you know?
I think we just kind of like stumbled upon cool things that made the music better by not really having an agenda. If something was improvised and it was great, we kept it and we weren't, you know, sacred about it. Through playing with the people that we play with outside of the Beta Machine, you can't help but be inspired. And one person, you know, is Matt Mitchell. So we get to work with him all the time. He's the person that gets to, at the end of the day, walk us off the plank. Like, no. Like, come on back. Yeah. You know, whether we're like, Matt and I are like, no, we should do this and this. He determines at the end of the day whether
it's... Dude, it sounds great. We're like, well, if he thinks it sounds great, then it probably sounds great.
Exactly. We learned that about his process by, you know, doing Pussifer Records. We'd think, oh, this is a great idea. Like, awesome, dude. It's pretty much done, right? And the next day we come in, he's like, I broke it. I broke the whole thing open and changed this and this and your drum part's this now and blah, blah, blah. Like, holy shit. We didn't think it would be better, but it is.
I think the real testament to who they are as artists and as people is that they take on the challenge, that it's not that we can't do it, it's just like they're willing to put in the hard work and they're gonna figure it out if they don't know it. We kind of started working immediately as, like, you know, artist producer, in that, you know, we had done an album, but we decided, just in the nature of what Pussifer does, we're gonna turn this upside down. So we're gonna do this song, but we want you to reinterpret it. So walk away with the song you know and bring us something else. So then it's on them to, like, wow, here's what we have. Is this cool? And you know, and then I would take that and I'd be like, okay, well, this is cool, but this isn't so cool. It was immediately a creative kind of bouncing back and forth that we've had kind of from day one. Having a full length thing to explore, it was, you know, hundreds and hundreds of ideas for everything, and if anything, what's taken the time is just to sort through all the ideas and decide which things we want to keep and which things, you know, we save for the next record.
The transition from the studio to live sometimes involves taking some of the synth parts, the programmed parts with all these cool, really rare things that Matt has, and converting those to the guitar or converting them to the bass. So the guitar has kind of a really interesting role in the bass too, is that it's not always the traditional thing. It's not always just playing power chords or even the parts that we did on the record. Sometimes it can be filling a few different roles.
There's like those weird parts that, like, sometimes you can't even tell what it is.
You can't tell. Like, yeah.
We had a lot of fun actually. Like, guitars was like this whole plethora of pedals. And you were just in there, like,
right,
just playing all this shit, like, let's do another one, just like tweak,
totally.
Tweak, tweak.
Yeah.
Because of the other projects we play in, I think maybe from an outsider's perspective, they're thinking like, this is this side project thing. But, you know, our hope is that we're conveying the message through this record that it's not a project, that it is a legitimate band that's gonna see the light of day.